So you've got your 85X and you're getting a clog, or your filament isn't passing through here. How do you get it out of here? Well, one way you can pull it from, well, from the IFS way and pull it up. But if it breaks here, how do you get this little piece out? Well, I'll show you. Grab the front off. There's a C-clip here. Easiest way to get the C-clip out is you grab a screwdriver, put your thumb, a flathead screwdriver, sorry. You get your thumb against it. Otherwise, it's going to literally fly across the room, which I've had done before. Then there's another little clippy, I don't know what to call it, coupler clip or something like that here. You grab your screwdriver and push down. Push down, and then it will pop out. Then your filament can come out here. You can push it from the IFS side. It'll come all the way out. One clue to look for is if you've got a clog, is if this filament comes out and it's a little squirrely at the bottom instead of having a nice clean cut at the bottom. And now I will show you how to unclog your nozzle. You can do one way is heat it up to 260 and just push this filament through with your hand, like I'm doing here. Push it through and it will come through here, push it all the way through here. You do have to release this screw, which is the filament extruder gear. So release the filament extruder gear, then that'll allow the filament to flow all the way through. Huh, that's not actually hot to touch, and we're at 260. So what will happen is, yeah, you can push the filament through. I find the easier way is to move that out of the way, and you grab some filament off the ground, which you always have on the ground, and pop it through here. And it'll be a little bit tricky to push through, but you'll see it'll come through. This is at temperature. So this is at 260 degrees. Push it through and then do a quick pull up. And that'll bring out any of the excess filament that's been hanging around. As you can see there, that I just did a clear with that one. And if you're enjoying this content on the 85X, let me know in the comments. If you don't like it, too bad. It spits out the bottom. So it just spits it out and out and out and out. So you just spit it all the way out and then pop it out real quick. And it should give you a little dangle. And you see there's a tiny bit of black when there shouldn't be. So that means you've got a partial clog. Snip it off, do it again, push it in, give it a bit of a robustness. Just going to get this out the way for now. Push it in, and pull. So we've got white filament now. Chop it clean again and do it another couple of times. I like to do it about three or four times just to be sure. Because you see, I'm trying to get it. Yeah. I'm trying to get it in the hole. Or I've created a whole new issue. Well, I believe I have. Well, I've definitely bunged it up somehow, haven't I? This is the fun part. Okay. Well, now, let's try something else. Since I've really completely cooked this, hey? It actually comes out a really long way. I'm going to put it down and hopefully not lose it. If we check, it only comes down to here. So, interesting. Okay. Well, this is why we do this stuff. I'm going to cool it down. And I will have to remove this part here, I think. Using the same screwdriver. Yeah, the same screwdriver. Now we can actually see inside. Let's see if it even gets down that far. It doesn't. So what we can do is push up. Up in there. No. Still doesn't want to. Which is an inch. Aha. No, we got it, I think. Aha. Yes, so a little bit of filament got stuck cold up in here, between here and here, which is cold. which means you can't actually push the filament through to go into the nozzle. We took these two screws off here, just covered, and then pushed up, and then we're able to get that out. It's amazing. We can pop this back in, cover the hole back up without losing a screw. And this is why we do this stuff, to learn, and also to break our stuff, which, you know, someone else wouldn't have known. Oh. Okay, as it's doing that, I'm going to heat it up again to 60. I guess that's the downside of doing a fast hot pull, is there's a potential of some extra filament getting stuck in there. Cool. So now we chuck the extruder screw back in. And how do you know how tight to make it? Well, I don't. I'm going to put it back to how it was, and hopefully we're good. I'm going to put it tight, but one half screw back. Then we pop the top back in and get our flathead screwdriver again, because of this latch, remember? Make it click, and then chuck your C-clip back in. Well, so there you go. That's a few different ways to get rid of head clogs, nozzle clogs, or extruder clogs.